हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 10 फिजिक्स क्लास। इन चाइल्डहुड वी एवरी वन ऑल्सो स्टडी वन पोएम, दैट इज ट्विंकल ट्विंकल लिटिल स्टार, हाउ आई वॉन्टर व्हाट यू आर। तुम लोग यही सोच रहे हो कि मैं ये पोएम क्यों बोल रही हूँ। ट्विंकल ट्विंकल लिटिल स्टार, ये पोएम तो हम लोगों ने पढ़ा है, हम लोगों को याद भी है, बट एनी टाइम डिड यू थिंक अबाउट द रीज़न बिहाइंड द ट्विंकलिंग ऑफ स्टार्स? व्हाई स्टार्स आर ट्विंकल? यस डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज क्लास ऑल अबाउट दिस matter, that is twinkling of stars, and the reason is atmospheric refraction. So welcome students. So today's class is very interesting topic we discuss, that is atmospheric refraction, and due to that atmospheric refraction how stars are twinkle. Another one application, that is advanced sunrise and delayed sunset. So without any delay, let's start today's class. So first we discuss the atmospheric refraction, then one by one I will discuss the twinkling of stars, advanced sunrise, delayed sunset. Okay, so what do you mean by atmospheric refraction? Refraction means, we know that refraction means the change in direction of a ray of light when it travels from one medium to another medium, or bending of light rays, that is called refraction. And that two mediums, one is optically rarer medium and another one is optically denser medium, so that is called refraction. We already studied that one. But atmospheric refraction, why we say that atmospheric refraction? That means this type of refraction is takes place inside the atmosphere. We know that our Earth is surrounded by many layer of the atmosphere, or the many air layers with different densities. And we know that if the densities are different, so whenever the light rays are travel from one layer to another layer, it will suffer from refraction. Either it will be far away from the normal or towards the normal, that is depends upon the condition from where to where the rays of light travel, denser to rarer, rarer to denser. But it changes direction, or it bending, light rays are bent. Because inside the atmosphere or in the this layer, different layers, this refractions happens. That's why this type of refraction is called atmospheric refraction. We know that this air layers, some of the air layers are cold, and some of the air layers are comparatively warm, that means hotter wave, hotter layers. And whenever the light rays travel from that hotter air to colder air, or colder air to hotter air, the light rays changes direction or bends because of this different optical densities and different air layers. This refraction, this refractions of light caused by the Earth's atmosphere having different air layer with different optical densities is called atmospheric refraction. I hope it is clear it now. Why it is called atmospheric refraction, not only the refraction, that there is also the rays of light is bends or changes direction, but the condition inside the atmosphere of the different layer of the air, which having different densities, some having higher densities, some having lower densities, cold air, hotter air. So refraction is takes place by the Earth atmosphere, that is called, that's why it is called atmospheric refraction. Okay. Now, if we look at object through the hot air over a fire, anytime did you experience this matter? You and your friend suppose sitting over there, and in the middle there some fires are there. So if you want to see the face of your friends through over this over a fire, you see that the object appears to be slightly moving just above the air, just above the fire becomes hotter. And this hotter air is optically rarer. Those are the hotter air, these are the optically rarer. But the colder air further up is optically denser. So when we see the objects in the light, by the light coming from them through hot and cold air layers having different optical densities, the refraction of light takes place randomly due to the objects appear to be moving slightly. The air layers, those having the different densities, these densities are not constant. Continuously, from a fraction of second, these densities continuously changes. And due to this changing in density, whenever the light rays, the reflected light rays also moving or slightly it's moving. That's why the image of the object also moving, appears to be moving slightly. Clear? Okay. Under normal circumstances, the air in the upper atmosphere is optically rarer. As we come down, the air in the lower atmosphere is optically denser in the normal conditions, if no fire is there. Because there is a fire is there, so the air layer which is near to the fire, it is becomes hotter, and which layer, air layer is present above that hotter air layer, that is become colder. So colder air means denser and the hotter means rarer. But normal condition, normal days, the air in the upper atmosphere at the upper air layer is optically rarer, and which is close to the Earth's surface, the air layer is the lower atmosphere, that is optically denser. It is in under the normal circumstances. You see that the sun is that time, the sun is that side, from the rays of light is coming from sun. So sun is an example of the fire. So whatever the air layer near the sun, that is becomes hotter. So from Earth, that will be the upper atmosphere. That's why for respect to Earth, that upper atmosphere is optically rarer, and the layer which is near to the Earth's surface, that is becomes optically denser. Now, some optical phenomena in nature which occur due to the atmospheric refraction of light, already we in at the study, we already know that one phenomena, that is twinkling of stars, twinkle twinkle little star. Yes, twinkling of stars. Why stars are twinkling? If anybody write due to the only the atmospheric refraction. Yes, the main reason is atmospheric refraction, but how that atmospheric refraction takes place and why the stars twinkle. So we know that the stars has their own light, that is called starlight. They will emit their own light. and due to this light the stars shine in the night sky. When we look at the star in the sky on a clear night, we observe that the intensity of light coming from it changes continuously. Sometimes it will be brighter, sometimes it will be dim. Because of this, we see that stars are twinkling. Sometimes brighter, sometimes dim, sometimes brighter, sometimes dim. And we say that stars twinkle at night. So the main reason behind the twinkling of star is due to the atmospheric refraction of star's light. So how this refraction is takes place, let's study that one. So whenever the light coming from the star, that is star light, and it enters in the earth atmosphere, as we know that the earth atmosphere has different air layers with different densities. And in a normal circumstances, the upper layer has the optically rarer medium, and the layer near the surface, it will be optically denser medium. Okay, so whenever the starlights coming from stars enter in the earth's atmosphere, it undergoes refraction due to the different optical densities of air at different layers. And this densities of the atmosphere continuously changing, due to which the optical densities of air at different level in the atmosphere keep on changing. The temperature, main reason is temperature. The temperature is not constant. Temperature also varied. That's why the atmosphere continuously changes. That means the density, optical densities at the different layer of the air also changes. Now, so layer to one layer for upper layer to next layer to next layer. That means rarer to denser. Upper layer is rarer. So after that, that one is a denser compared to the upper layer. So, and we know that whenever the air light rays travel from rarer to denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. So, like this way, in every layer, if we draw a perpendicular, we see that in every time due to the refraction of light, the refracted light bend towards the normal. Clear? And because this atmospheric densities are not constant, they will continuously changes. Due to this continuously changing atmosphere, refracts the light from stars by different amounts from one moment to the next. That means the refraction is takes place is okay. But whenever that refracted rays of light reaches to our eyes, sometimes more light enters in our eyes. That's why we see that this is a bright, the stars twinkle at bright light. And due to this changing of densities, the less amount of light are refracted, and that refracted rays of light will enter in our eyes. So we see that the stars are dim. So due fraction of second, that star sometimes it will be brighter. After few seconds, it will be dim. So one brighter, one dim, because of this changing densities in a different layer of the atmosphere. And because of this, we say that stars are twinkling. This is the reason behind the twinkling of stars. So when the atmosphere refracts more starlight towards us, or towards the observer, the star appear to be brighter. And when the atmosphere refracts, if the optical densities are changed, so due to that changing in densities, the atmosphere refracts less starlight, then the less amount of starlight reaches towards the observer, and then the star appears to be dim. So the whatever the starlight reaching our eyes, sometimes it will increases, sometimes it will decreases continuously. continuously for a fraction of a second. Just now you see that it is brighter. Just now you see it is dim. So it is continuously increases and decreases due to this atmospheric refraction and due to this changing densities in the different layer of the atmosphere. And that's why we say that stars are twinkle, 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 little star. So whenever this type of questions will come, that give reason why behind twinkling of stars or why stars are twinkle. So whenever you write these points, so you also draw the diagram. In this diagram, you see that. Okay, one thing due to this, in this figure, you see that the A position and B position. Okay, after the atmospheric refraction, that bending rays of light, when it reaches to our eyes, the one main condition of our eyes, that is our eyes cannot travel in a curved path. It always in a straight path. It always in a straight path. Does not follow the curved path. Our eyes always follow the straight path. So whenever due to the atmospheric refraction, whenever the refracted rays either increase or decrease, it is happening continuously. So some starlights are entered in our eyes, and if when we see, look at the sky, night sky, we see whatever the position of the star, that is not the actual position of the star. From this figure you see that, because whatever the actual position, from there the light will start traveling or start refraction when it enters in an Earth atmosphere. Due to many times it will be refracted, 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 then it will come into our eyes, but our eyes does not follow the curved path or the bending path of the light. So if we extend that line, that's why we use the dotted line, we see the apparent position of the star. This is not the actual position of the star. This is not the actual position of the star. This type of question also will come, that why this will happen, and that the position of the star in the night sky, is this a actual position or the apparent position? Yeah, this is the whatever we see in the night sky, that is the apparent position of the star, not the actual position. It will be shifted, and always the apparent position is higher than its actual position, not the lower. Always it is a higher than its actual position. An increase in density and the refractive index, its density is increases and refractive index also increases whenever the light rays travel upper layer to the towards the Earth surface, upper atmosphere layer to the Earth surface. Its increase density also increases, rarer to denser, and refractive index also increases. I hope it is clear what is the reason behind the twinkling of stars, and whatever the star's position or whatever the stars we see in the night sky, that is not the actual position of the star. This is the apparent position of the star, because our eyes does not follow the bent path or the curved path. It is always follow the straight line path. So due to that straight line path, what is the apparent position of the star, that is always higher than its actual position. I hope it is clear. Like this way it will be refracted. You see that this is the Earth's atmosphere, lights from star, and it will be like this way, it will bend. It will refract it, and this refraction is continuously changes. Sometimes it will be right side, then zigzag path due to this changing density. Due to that changing density, they will follow the zigzag path, and that's why we see that stars sometimes it looks brighter, sometimes look dim. Now one more question it's arise. Why stars are twinkle at night, not the planets? Planets do not twinkle at all. Yes, one. This is also very, very important topic. The stars appear very, very small to us because the stars are situated very, very, very far off distance. So stars looks stars appear a point object. Stars look at a point object because the distance from the earth to the star is more. And because of this, star can be considered to be a point source of light or point object. The continuously changing atmosphere is able to cause the variation in the light coming from a point sized star, because of which star appear to be twinkle. But the planet appears to be big to us because they are much nearer to the earth. They are much nearer to the earth. You know, we have the 9 planets, and these planets are much nearer to the earth compared to the stars. So planet cannot be considered as a point source. It can be considered as a collection of huge number of point source. Stars only one point source is there, but the planet is considered, the many point source are included inside it. It is a collection of very large number of point sources of light. And due to that, the dimming effect produces by some of the point source of light in one part of the planet is nullified by the brighter effect produced by the point source of light in its other part. Thus, the brightness of the planet always remains same, and hence it does not appear to twinkle. That means, if suppose we consider the planets as a collection of huge number of point sources, if suppose one point source is very, very dim, no light is coming from that point source, but the other point source is nullified that effect because the brighter point source also overcome this problem, this difficulties. So what happened? So if from one point source no light is coming, but the presence of the other brighter point sources, this problem will be finished. So as a whole effect, the brightness of the planet is constant, remains same, it will not change. If it will not change, because in case of a star, it will changes. That's why sometimes it will looks like a brighter object, sometimes dim object, because there from due to the atmosphere, sometimes we get it will reflect it more amount of light, sometimes it will reflect it less amount of light from the atmosphere, not from the stars. From the stars, the uniform light rays are traveled, but whenever they will enter inside the Earth's atmosphere, because and that densities also changes, because of this, sometimes the atmosphere refracted more amount of light rays, and we see that the stars becomes a brighter, and sometimes it will less amount of light rays, it will be refracted, so we see that the star will be dimmer. But this is in case of a star, but this will not happen in case of a planet. As a whole, the brightness of a planet always same, it is fixed, and hence it does not appear to twinkle. The continuously changing atmosphere is unable to cause the variation in the light coming from a big size planet due to refraction, because of which the planet does not twinkle at all. If one point source is dimmer, it will be nullified by the other presence of the other brighter sources, and that's why this brightness is fixed, and it will not cause any variation inside the atmosphere. That's why the planet does not twinkle at all. Is it clear? Okay. Now, already from that diagram, twinkling of the star, we see that the stars seem higher than they actually are. Why it's happening, already we discussed. Here also I will write in a language. If the question is there, then how you can write if it is there. That first of all, why the stars are twinkle, that you can write in very short form, in short language. And then you write that our eyes does not follow the curved path, it will always follow the straight line path. and due to that straight-line path, the apparent position of the star is always higher than the actual position. Due to the atmospheric refraction, the stars seem to be higher in the sky than they actually are. Light from star is refracted as it leaves space and enters the Earth atmosphere. At higher up in the sky is rarer, but the nearer the Earth surface is denser. So the light rays from star comes down, the dense air bends the light more. Due to this refraction of starlight, the star appeared to be at higher position. Our nearest star, the Sun, also seems higher than it actually is due to the atmospheric refraction. The Sun position, whatever the Sun's position, this is not also the actual position. Okay. Now, one question arises in my mind. Stars are twinkle. Sun is also a star. Can Sun also twinkle? This is one question. Can Sun also be twinkled? What is the answer behind it? Sun also be a star? It has own light. Yes, star or Sun also twinkle, but it not appear to us because Sun is situated very near to the Earth, and Sun's size is very, very bigger than the compared to the other stars. Like a planet, it is also considered as a very huge number of point sources, and all inside the Sun always the helium, nitrogen, oxygen, always the gaseous formation is and reaction is there. So due to this, if one point source is dimmer, it's not happening inside the Sun also, not dimmer. All sources are refracted equal amount of light, and because it is very close to the Earth surface, so the refraction also very less. Whenever it will reaches to our eyes, we see that the light coming from the Sun, it is constant, it is not varied. When no variation is there inside the atmosphere, or whatever the variation is occurred, that is a very less. That's why we see that star and Sun and the planets not twinkle, does not twinkle. Okay, I hope it is clear it now. Now the another one topic, application of atmospheric refraction, that is advance and rise and delayed sunrise. It is happening, you know, the whatever the time, actual time of the sunrise before 2 minutes, 2 minutes before we see the Sun in the sky, and same thing after 2 minutes the Sun already set under the below the horizon, but still we see that the Sun is there, that is delayed by 2 minutes. This is also happening because of the atmospheric refraction. 2 minutes before the actual sunrise, 2 minutes after the actual sunset, because of the atmospheric refraction. Now, if we talk about the sunrise, same thing will also happening for the sunset. Okay, sunrise, the actual sunrise takes place when the Sun is just above the horizon. Just above the horizon, that means we see the half circle, semicircle of the Sun is a circle. If we consider Sun is a circle, then just above the circle, that horizon, that means semicircle, that is called the actual sunrise. But due to the atmospheric refraction of sunlight caused by this atmosphere, we can see the Sun rise about 2 minutes before its actual time. When the Sun is slightly below the horizon, not above the view, slightly below the horizon, the Sun's light coming from less denser air, that is the upper layer of the Earth atmosphere, to more denser air is refracted downwards as it passes to the different atmospheric layers. And because there is a different densities also be there, so it will suffer atmospheric refraction So the rays of light which is coming from the sun, it is bend, and whenever it reaches to our eyes does not follow the bent path. And we already we studied that the whatever the apparent position, that apparent position always the higher than its actual position. So same thing is happening here also. So our eyes also already only follow the straight line path, and due to this we see that the apparent position of the star and this timing, the timing gap, that is a 2 minute, it is practically proved. So because of this atmospheric refraction, sun appears to be raised above the horizon when it's actually slightly below the horizon. Actual position is below the horizon, but because of this sunrise, we see that the sun already above the horizon, and this time gap is only the 2 minutes. 2 minutes before the sunrise, 2 minutes after the sunset. Did you understand? I hope it is clear. It is also due to atmospheric refraction that we can still see the sun for about 2 minutes even after the sun has set below horizon. Same thing also be happening. We can see the sun 2 minutes before actual sunrise time and 2 minutes after the actual sunset time. So the time from sunrise to sunset is increased by 2 plus 2, 4 minutes because of this atmospheric refraction. Okay, this is the diagram. The left hand side, the S, this one, rising sun, it's just below the horizon. So the light rays also suffer from the atmospheric refraction. Whenever it enters the observer eye, the eye follows the straight line path. So S1 is its apparent position of the sun. And same thing is happened from here also. Setting sun, so thus it will also suffer bending, the lights will bend due to the atmospheric refraction, but our eyes follow the straight line path, that is the S2. So we see the sun 2 minutes after the sunset above the horizon. Okay, this is the main reason because of the behind the advance sunrise and delayed sunset. See this one, actual image of the sun, the rays, red color rays, actual rays that is coming from the sun, and it when it enters in the atmospheric layers, the different layers here present, so it will suffer the atmospheric refraction, bends towards the normal, and like this way whenever it will reaches the observer eyes, the eyes follow the straight line path. That is a virtual image of the sun or the apparent position of the sun, which is above the horizon. But the actually sun is still just below the horizon. So up to 2 minutes, we see that virtual image of the sun. After 2 minutes, the just slightly above the sun will rise slightly above the horizon. So that is the actual sunrise. This is the horizon, the light rays, the atmospheric layers, it will travel the atmospheric refraction, and we see that apparent position of the sun. Clear? I hope it is clear. Still, if you have any problem, if you are facing any problem regarding atmospheric refraction, it is a very, very important topic. Okay. So, whenever at 5 o'clock, whenever your mother or father tell that, "Arey, suraj utke utho utho, tum kehna ki ye actual sunrise nahi hai, mom and dad, ye apparent sunrise hai, virtual image dekh rahe ho aap," tab aapki mummy papa ko aap samjha dena. ये क्यों होता है? Due to the atmospheric refraction. But still, if you have any problem, please write in a comment box. What is your problem? So in next video, first of all, I will discuss that problems. Then I will start the new next topic. So have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe. Ta-ta.